All right, hey guys, how you doing? Today this is Peter at sixthreezero.com. I am going to show you how to build the relaxed bike. If you need any help, please don't hesitate to call us at 310-982-2877 or email us at theteam@sixthreezero.com. I'm going to build this bike with the tools that are included. All right, so all I need is something to snip the zip ties. I'm going to use a utility blade. You can also use scissors. Here we go, let's open the box. Here's the bike. Inside is also a seat post. We have the rear rack. Parts box. And assembly booklet and tools right here. Inside this, you'll find the assembly booklet, a welcome package, and some tools to help you get the bike put together. I'm going to put it together with the tools that it comes with. However, it will be easier if you use a real set of tools, but these will be enough to get you by. Inside the tools, we have a multi-tool, a 5mm Allen wrench, a 6mm Allen wrench, and 4mm, so 4, 5, and 6mm Allen wrench. Plus one of the Allen wrenches, or two of the Allen wrenches have Phillips head fitting on the end. All right, let's go ahead and start to unpackage the bike a little bit. There are a lot of zip ties here, so. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the fork forward. The bike is packaged with the fork backwards so that it'll fit in the box. You're gonna turn it 180 degrees clockwise. And you can also remove this piece of this fork protector. This is not part of the bicycle. This is just packaging, so discard that. The bike will stand on its own now like this. The handlebar, of course, will go right here, and it's fitted onto this part, which is called the stem. So these parts come separately on the relaxed bike. That's specific to this bike. A lot of them, they come attached. With this bike, they come separate. That's okay. Let's go ahead and open up the stem. We'll take some packaging off. Now, very important, a lot of customers miss this, but on the end, there is a piece of plastic. This is actually garbage. This is just to protect it during shipping. So please discard the little piece of plastic that covers the end, and you'll see an iron colored wedge at the bottom. Okay? Now, grabbing my 6mm Allen wrench, I'm gonna go ahead and stick the stem down into the head tube. Again, a much faster process with a set of more professional tools, but these will get you by. Now I'll go ahead and put that in pretty securely. I'll give it all the torque I can. tighten it down. It's not quite straight. We can straighten it later after we got the front wheel in. Then we can use the same 6mm wrench and take off the clamp on the stem that will hold the handlebars. We'll take out both bolts. Got one and then two. Place the handlebar in the stem and put the clamp back on. Now we're going to replace these two bolts, of course, and put them where they go. But please note that you don't want to just tighten one down and then tighten the other one afterwards. You want to put them both in and tighten evenly. So we'll get them both started. Now we just have both bolts started, and then we'll go ahead and tighten them down evenly. I want to make sure that we tighten them exactly evenly as we go around. Tighten one a little bit, and then tighten the other one. Go back and forth. Tighten the front one. Tighten the back one. And later on, when you sit on the bike, you can adjust the handlebars forward or backward as you prefer. Probably you're going to want the handlebars set back about like that, so you can have a nice upright seating position. But you can adjust it exactly how you like it for your own riding style and your own body. But we'll set it like this for now. It should be about right. Now I'm going to put in the front wheel. The front wheel has the front fender attached to it. So let's get out the knife again, or your scissors. Cut this zip tie. Take the fender off. Put it in a safe place. You don't want the fender to get scratched or dented. I'm going to set it to the side right here very carefully. And we're going to put the front wheel in. To install the front wheel, you do not use any tools at all. It uses a special mechanism called a quick release skewer. So before you do anything with the front wheel, go ahead and open up your parts box. In which you will find pedals, a headset cover, which is really just a cosmetic piece. I should have put that in already, actually. I'll go back to that. This is the quick release skewer. This is what's used to attach the front wheel. Just a small rod with a lever on one end. There's also a bag of hardware. This is extra hardware. You should not need it in assembling the bike, but in case you do, it's provided, in case something is missing on the bicycle. This should have been marked extra, but it hasn't been. So anyway, that's extra hardware in case you need it. Most likely, you won't use any of those screws or nuts. Now to use the quick release, we're going to go ahead and take the nut off the end and one of the springs. And then we're going to find the hollow axle of the front wheel. Front wheel has a hollow axle. It's also a very short axle. It does not protrude beyond the edges of the fork where it will go. There's only about 1/8 of an inch of threaded material on either side, and the fork will rest on that. So remember, the axle is very, very short. and you do not use any tools to install the front wheel. We'll put the nut back on loosely. Got the prickly skewer here like this. So before we put the front wheel in, let's go ahead and take the packaging off here. And one more part, the brakes will be too tight to get the front wheel in. Don't worry, you also don't need to use tools to undo that. There's a quick release latch mechanism that opens the brakes just like that. It takes about 1 second. And then you can go ahead and put the wheel in. The tread on the front wheel on this bike is directional. It doesn't really matter, except for looks. It doesn't have a functional capability unless you plan on going about highway speeds in the rain. But you can tell which way is forward by matching it with the rear wheel. It doesn't really matter though. Then we go ahead and, holding the nut over here, we'll go ahead and spin the lever in the open position. You'll see the fork come to rest on the two little ends of the axle. And then we go ahead and attempt to close the lever. In this case, it's a little on the tight side. I'm gonna open it back up. I'm gonna loosen the nut just about an eighth of a turn here for what I need. And then I'll try again closing it, making sure that the wheel is centered in the fork. It looks good. I'll close it right up. And you want the lever to go past 180 degrees when you close it. You close it, it goes about 200 degrees. So it needs to go a little bit past 180. That's what locks the lever in place. Okay, and then you can see the wheel is firmly installed. We use no tools, spinning freely. Now we reattach the brakes using that other quick release mechanism. Now the brakes are reattached. Like that, we can give it a few squeezes and see how it is. In this case, we're gonna need a little adjustment. That's okay, it's very easy to do. It needs to be centered. So let's go ahead and take the rest of the packaging off now. By the way, I put the kickstand down so the bike is holding itself. On the wheels, you'll find some circular pieces of plastic. These are just for packaging. You can discard these. It's not part of the bicycle. Now, working from the bottom up, we'll start with the pedals. There's a right pedal and there's a left pedal, and it matters. The right pedal is marked with an R, and it has normal thread, which means to install it, you turn the pedal clockwise, in the clockwise direction. The left pedal is reverse threaded. It has a left-hand thread, so you have to turn the counterclockwise direction to install it. So it's the left pedal is backwards. One easy way to remember is that you turn both of them towards the front of the bike to install them. We'll start with the right pedal. The right side of the bike is the side that's on the right when you're riding the bike. So we'll go ahead and start it. Again, putting it in the clockwise direction or towards the front of the bike. Get that nice and secure. You can get it pretty far with just your hand or your fingers. And then once you need to tighten it down, go ahead and use the multi-tool or a 15 millimeter wrench. And go ahead and get that as tight as you can. You want the pedals to be very secure. In a bike shop, often they will put grease on the pedals. It's not necessary for the function of the bike, but in case you leave the bike out in bad weather for a long time, the grease will help you remove the pedals later on. Here's the left pedal. I'm going ahead and going to put this one in by turning it counterclockwise. So it's going to feel backwards it feels like you're turning it the wrong way, but it's backwards threaded, it's reverse threaded. So we're turning it counterclockwise instead of the normal clockwise. Going as far as we can with just our hands and fingers. And then now I'll go ahead and tighten it with the 15 millimeter opening of my multi-tool. Again, if you have a more professional set of tools, you can maybe use a 15 millimeter wrench if you have one. It has to be a little bit narrow though to catch the pedal. So there we go. I like to do that first because there's no seat or anything that's in my way. I do have the handlebars here though. All right, so we're looking really good now. Let's go ahead and secure the fenders. You'll find there is a long screw or a bolt here actually at the top of the fork. Go ahead and take the fender, remove that bolt and the two washers and the nut. Take the packaging off of the fender. Here it is. We're gonna slip it in from behind. There's a tab on the fender. And that tab will go in right in behind the fork. Then we'll stick the bolt back in. The bolt goes through the hole and then the tab. And then, I'm sorry, there's a small thicker washer that has a concave curved side to it. We're gonna put that first and then the fender on. And then the washer and then the nut. The nut is a lock nut, so it has nylon in it. The nut is a lock nut, so it has nylon inside. So it has nylon inside the threads. So you'll only be able to turn it on about halfway with your fingers. At that point, you'll have to use a tool. Sometimes customers are unfamiliar with that, but after putting the nut on about halfway, you'll have to use a tool, which will be a Phillips and a 10 millimeter wrench, or you can use the 10 millimeter opening on the multi-tool. Again, this is much, much faster with, say, a socket set, but you can definitely get together with the multi-tool. And that's why we're doing it this way, to show you that even if you don't have, you know, your own tools at home, you can get by and make it happen. So we're gonna secure this, make it as tight as we can. Fenders will need to be centered and adjusted after installation. Because with fenders, it's not an exact science. There's a lot of variability with the way that a fender will go on, depending on, you know, where you have it centered on the fork and where you put the, you know, where you put the slot on the bolt, and a lot of different factors like that. So we will almost always need to adjust the fender after installation to make sure it's not rubbing the tire or the brakes aren't hitting it. It's not hard to do, but sometimes folks are surprised that that has to be done, but that is absolutely normal. Now we're going to loosen these two 5 millimeter screws on the bottom. These are 5 millimeter screws on the bottom here for the fender brackets. Go ahead and take those out. Again, all the hardware that you need should already be on the bike. And then we'll just go ahead and put them right back in. There's one, and then here comes number two. Easy peasy, slides right in. Now the fender's looking good. If I squeeze the brakes, yep, the brakes clear, everything clears, the wheel. The wheel is actually hitting on one side. I'm kind of glad so that I can show you. If I turn the wheel this way, you'll see that there's plenty of area right here. There's a lot of clearance on this side, but on this side, it's actually touching, okay? I'm gonna fix this really quickly. I'm gonna go like this. There, I fixed it. Now watch, when I pick it up, whoop, did a little too far. There we go, just adjust the fender how we need it. Oh, And it's because the brakes need to be adjusted, actually. But now the wheel is free of the fender, and we need to adjust the brakes. But we'll get to that in a moment. Let me just show you when I unhook the brakes. When the brakes are clear, we'll get to the brakes later, but when the brakes are clear, you can see the wheel is clear of the fender. And all I did for that was I just pat it over to the side. That's all it has to do, just clear the wheel. I'm gonna go ahead and reattach the brakes. We'll get to those later. On this particular one, the right brake pad is dragging a little bit. Super easy fix. There's a centering screw on there that's made for that. Okay, we just installed the front fender. Now let's get to the rear fender. We can take the plastic packaging off. There we go. By the way, we're always looking to improve our videos and our manuals, so we welcome all feedback, we really do. We're always trying to improve on those, so please don't hesitate to give us an email if you want. If you have some ideas or suggestions or something wasn't quite clear to you, let us know. What I'm doing right now is I'm removing all of the hardware that is in the frame. There are six screws, 5mm screws, three on each side. We're gonna use these for the rack and for the rear fender. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the rack right here. I'm gonna use a top set of screws on the bottom for the rack. I'll get one screw started. These are 5mm screws right here. On this bike, the rack arms are a little bit tight, so I'm just gonna pull it out to get it to fit right here. I had to pull it out just about a half an inch there. To get around the frame that I installed the screw. While you're doing this, be very careful not to scratch or scrape or otherwise harm the fender while you're installing the rear rack. Now it's time to install the front part. It's also gonna have to be spread out a little bit there. It's just a little bit of a tight fit. It's not a problem, it's actually a good thing. Makes for a nice snug and a positive attachment when you install the screws. So these are the 5mm. Go ahead and install these. I'm sorry, I apologize. These are 4mm. So use the small Allen wrench that you have. 4mm ones go up top. Go ahead and cinch that down. Looking good. I need to use a 5mm here at the bottom. I'm sorry, also 4mm. Use a 4mm at the bottom as well. It's always been a mystery to me why sometimes they use 4mm, sometimes 5, sometimes 6. It'd be nice if it was all one size. This rack can carry about 15 pounds. That's what it's rated for. So it's good for carrying some of your things to the beach or across campus. I wouldn't put a person on this, let a person sit on this. If you do want a child seat will come with its own rack, actually. So I don't know of child seats that would fit on this rack, and I wouldn't recommend it. But when you buy a child seat, it will come with its own rack. So you would remove this one and then add the child seat with its own rack onto this bike. Most of them are pretty universally compatible with most bikes. We like the top beak. That one works really well with our bikes. So now I'm attaching the bottom part, the struts of the fender, with again a 4mm screw here going into the frame. As a reminder, highly likely the fender will not be exactly centered once we secure it with the screws. That's to be expected, and we'll just straighten it out a little bit with a little tap or nudge here or there. But we'll see how it looks. So here we go. Tightening that 4mm screw down. All right, if I were to detach the brakes here with that simple quick release mechanism, as before, see they were released and open. Now the wheel is free of the brakes. Let's just pick it up, pick the bike up and see if it's running free of the fender or not. Yeah, it looks really nice. The fender also looks nicely centered, but if it weren't, I would give it a little hit like this, a little tap, a little nudge like that, do what I have to make it centered. In this case, it's perfect, it's ready to go, but there's nothing wrong with kind of giving a little push and a nudge to the struts here, make it how it needs to be so that it doesn't rub on the wheel or tire. Okie doke. These are the extra screws again and bolts. Don't be afraid of all these. They're not needed for the assembly of the bike. Everything you need is on the bike, but we include them because every now and then a part might be missing. It happens. So they're there in case you need them. Also, you might need them later on, who knows? Okay, let's go ahead and I'm gonna reattach these brakes that I just detached to check the fender clearance. Again, a quick operation, took me a couple seconds there. Squeezing the brakes here. I can see that this one needs to be centered as well, so we'll do that in a later operation. Let's go ahead and put the seat tube in. Not the seat tube, this is called a seat post. This is actually the seat tube. You can, if you like, and it's common practice in a bike shop to put grease on the seat post before you stick it in here into the seat tube. The reason for that is that, again, it is possible after a long time, if the bike is left out in inclement weather, that these metal parts can seize. It's not a super common occurrence, and you don't need to grease these parts for the function of the bike, but you can always do it as a safety precaution in case you want to guard against that and to be able to raise and lower the seat post or remove it later on if the bike experiences extreme corrosion. So this has a quick release system, just like we did to install the front wheel. So we're gonna put the seat post in. You'll find out how high you need it later on. Right here, it's bottoming out about right here. We're gonna go ahead and tighten the nut while the lever is open. So the lever's open. Now it's very, very important that you close the lever correctly in the correct position. If you don't do it the right way, you will probably break it because there is a tremendous amount of torquing power in the length of this lever. Even though it's short, it can snap the bolt that is attached to if you do it wrong. So if you try to, for instance, I'm going to do it very lightly, try to close this in the upward position, two things. One, it's not going to hold the seat post. Two, trying to get tight enough, you're going to have enough leverage power to snap the bolt. When you do the quick release, it needs to lay right across the body of the seat post clamp. It will spoon it, actually. They will nest against each other, just like that. So on this particular bike, most bikes, it goes forward along the body of the seat post clamp. But in this case, we clamp it towards the backwards position. And it goes right there, nests right along, and spoons the body of the seat post clamp. And the opening part of the seat post clamp has to be lined up with the slot in this seat tube. And then that will hold the seat post in securely. I'm gonna raise it up to give myself a little bit of room when I put the seat post in. I mean, the seat in itself. The seat is gonna be a 6mm. So this will take me just a little while because I don't have a hex end on this, it has a Phillips. Again, another reason to have a more professional set of tools, but I'll show you that it can be done quickly and easily with the set that is given. We're gonna take the bolt out. We're gonna remember the order that these seat clamp is in. It's a nice long bolt there. So we got the bottom part, the top, they just sandwich over the rails of the seat, and then the nut, of course, secures everything. So I'm gonna put the bottom part on again. I'm going to open up the seat. Seat's called a saddle in the cycling world, but we found it's just makes more sense to call it a seat. Sounds a little foreign to call it a saddle for most casual riders. There are rails on the bottom of the seat, and that will rest right onto the clamp. And then the top part of the clamp will come in on the top and sandwich the two rails like this. Rest it on there. We'll put that nut on its little spot where it can rest there on the concavity of the top part of the clamp. So we go ahead and we got the seat clamp put how we like it. It's a little bit loose. We can adjust the angle of the seat up, down, however you like it. Usually you want to start off with it about level to the ground, and after you ride it, you'll know if you want it adjusted in some different way. You can also, you have some movement forward and backward as well. So that's a nice extra adjustment to be able to have. Once again, a ratcheting Allen is a much beloved tool for this sort of situation, but we'll be using the little set we've been given here in the bike box, which even so will get us through this rather easy assembly. Here we go. Give it a nice good turn. We can lower the seat to where we want it. I need to make the seat clamp a little tighter, so I'm going to go ahead and turn on the nut a little bit and then close that clamp right up against the body of the seat post clamp. There it goes. And just straighten that up. All right. At this point, the bike is actually already done. One last thing is you're going to want to fully air up the tires. They will be normally they'll be full enough to ride, but you'll get a much better ride if you pump these up all the way to maximum pressure, which on these, let me just double check, I think it's 60, should be 65 PSI. 40 PSI on these guys is the maximum. So go ahead and inflate those all the way. Having them inflated fully will give you a much, much better ride. It's very surprising, and all bicycle tires do lose air over time. Even after a week or two on any bike, the air pressure can go down. And it has a subtle effect on your riding. You won't notice the effect, but if you were to compare back to back, difference between a low pressure tire and high pressure tire, the riding difference is very, very different. So I would recommend keeping it at 40 pounds per square inch, and top it off every week or so. If you're gonna ride, definitely once a month, and it'll make your ride much better. I did forget one part here. This little piece is not necessary, but is a cosmetic guy. This little ring here, it actually goes right here. I'll go ahead and put that on for you so that you know how to do it. I'm gonna loosen this up here. We need to loosen this anyway because we wanna straighten it up, get aligned with the front wheel. So we'll loosen this a little bit. Then I can pull this out here. We'll take this headset cover, slip it over the stem. Bring it up a little higher. Like so. We'll put the stem back into the head tube, and then you can re-secure by tightening the stem bolt with the 6mm Allen wrench. Tighten that down. I like to stand over the front wheel to get that lined up so you can hold the front wheel with your legs, and then close one eye and get that stem nicely lined up. And you just have to eyeball it. If it feels like it's one way or the other, once you start riding, you can readjust. And then once you have that, go ahead and take the cover and push it all the way down over the top of the headset, and it makes for a nice clean look. At this point, we can just remove this packaging here. One last piece here. This bike is ready to go. I did have to make a small centering adjustment on the brakes here, I noticed. That's very easy. You can just use your screw here, and we have video for that to show you how to center the brakes. But it's just a matter of turning these small centering screws inward. You want to turn inward on the one that needs to be pulled away. It's a little bit counterintuitive. Give a few squeezes. Turn the other side too. All right, so thank you for watching the video for the relaxed bike. This sequence will work for the men's and the women's bikes. It's the exact same procedure. This happens to be, it's not really a men's bike. We kind of move away from men's and women's. It's a step through frame, but it's got, you know, the matte black coloring that is often preferred. But it also comes in a navy and teal version. Same instructions. I would take it for a test ride, check how the brakes work, check how the gears work. And then adjust if needed. Again, if you need any help, please don't hesitate to ask. And call us 310-982-2877 or email us at theteam@sixthreezero.com, and we'll get back to you with answer, or we'll get back to you if we miss you. All right, thanks a bunch. Take care and enjoy the ride.